We'll be right back. Gentlemen, welcome to the finals. This is for all the marbles. We got 200 people already in the stream. We're going to have a heck of a lot more. My name is John Strowski with Rod Trudell, Markham Waxers, Waterloo Wolves. Let's go. I'm just going to, before the PA announcer gets on the mic, I'm going to quickly shout out the graduating players. For Waterloo, there is none. They are a team full of 07s. Nobody is graduating from this program this year. For the Markham Waxers, these are the graduating players. Number 29, Eamon Callahan. Number 13, Nathaniel Adams. Number 17, Ryan Piggott. Number 34, Amari Wharton. Number 58, Adam Solomon. Number 78, Aiden Burt. Number 91, Matthew Johnson. And number 92, Nathan Helfenstein. Congratulations and best of luck in your future endeavors, gentlemen. We're gonna bring it to the PA announcer and we'll be back in a minute. To thank our sponsor for today, Sioux Concussion Clinic. Sioux Concussion Clinic is the Sioux's longest running and most trusted concussion specialty facility. We offer diagnosis and rehabilitation of acute and chronic concussions, no matter the mechanism of injury. Treatment and management is individually tailored on a case-by-case basis. In addition to post-injury care, we also offer preventative education and preseason/in-season baseline testing. Call Dr. Albert and Merlino at Sioux Concussion Clinic, located at 644 Queen East, 595-4665.
Welcome back. That's it for the national anthems. I'm Rod Trudell. I'll be doing play-by-play. Like you said, John Ostrowski's with me, along with Chris Carr on the camera. Jay Houselander's producing. So we thank you for joining us here at Sioux Sports TV. And we are just going to get right to the action here as
yes,
the referees are pumping fists. They're jacked, ready to go, and I think the teams are too. Waterloo starts banging their sticks. If that was me and I was a dad, I would be like, don't bang your stick. It costs $400. And it comes back. Senkai moves it up, pushing it to the D. Here comes Mikko Giannakis puts it back, and there's Oldenhoff. Oldenhoff pushes it over to Senkai. Senkai puts it up. Mikko Giannakis sends it in deep, Piggott's after it, and we will get a stoppage of play by the Waterloo Wolves as Bree just puts his mitt over top and will take the face off to his left.
Starting goaltenders for this evening, no surprises here. Number one for Waterloo, Jack Bree, and number 29 for the Markham Waxers, Eamon Callahan.
And there they go, try and wrap it around. That was Mikko Giannakis. Goes back to Oldenhoff, back there, tries to shoot, can't do it. Rutledge has it. He's got Vineski with him. Goes up, hits the mesh, and it'll be another stoppage of play there.
And pretty big day for two of the affiliate players the other evening.
Miller's out there, and Miller, pardon me.
Oh, he's got
Miller's
a
out there, and he's got a name bar now.
Oh, wow. Yeah, so a pretty big day for two of those guys, both Matt Miller and Brody Strauss getting drafted to the OHL. Miller went to the – I'm going to have to look at my notes in a second. And Brody Strauss went to the Brantford Bulldogs.
That's awesome. So here we go. Puck comes out all the way to the front. Senkai misses that. Goes back to Oldenhoff. Oldenhoff turns, comes into the center ice, can't keep the puck. Big number 88 on that now. That's Beasel. Beasel, he can't.
Whoa!
Gets checked, and there we go. Some physical stuff. Vanderberg's in hard on Burt. Burt sends it around to his partner, and then send it back out. Here comes Johnson. He's someone to worry about. That's for
sure.
Yeah,
he is.
Now there it is, number 39. That's Vanderberg. He gets it down into neutral zone. Burt goes D to D. Back across again, back to Burt. Burt moves that puck all the way up, and Cruz is able to chip that all the way in. And here comes Speedy Adams.
Yeah,
he'll go in there and get that puck, no problem. There he is again. He's looking to center it. He tries. Can't get it out. Goes off the boards. Comes all the way down. We're going to have an icing.
And just to correct my previous call, Matthew Miller went to the Guelph Storm. He was the 224th pick, and Strauss was the 296th pick. Talked to both of their fathers yesterday, and they were just so amped, and I'm sure they're amped right now, as is everyone in this stadium. It's
here
quite packed in here.
Yeah, and here's puck drop. And there we go. That will be the Wolves taking control. He flip it up, but Burt keeps it in. But McCluskey's on him. McCluskey, he's still on him. He gets it, dumps it in deep, and they'll chase after it. Miller's going to get to that puck. He tries. He's on the guy. Can't keep there. So the Waxer's
moving out.
Here we go. Comes up, and it goes. Straight into the cookie jar. Backhand.
That started with Adams' cross-ice pass. A double-line pass there straight to Cruzet. He was wide open, had so much ice. Unbelievable. That starts with Nathan Adams right there in the assist,
sir. Quick gut start to the game for the Waxers and these Waterloo Wolves. They're not used to being behind, that's for sure.
Yeah, no, they're not.
I don't think they've been behind once yet. They are. They have won every game so far. So here we go. The Waxers are tuned in, and it's going to be a doozy. Back to behind the net, and the goalie comes out and plays. It's Schofield, puts it back behind the net to Craig. Craig out front, and then number 7, he just cannot get a stick on it. Fry, Caswell tries to put it towards the net. He sends out Mikko Jonikas. He's up. He's trying to streak in. Now he's got Piggott on the far side, and Piggott shoots. Can't keep it in there. There's number 5 on that back end, Koza, and he puts it in. And it goes all the way into the corner. Mikko Jonikas is on it now. Rutledge is fighting the puck. Mikko Jonikas comes out with a pop, it shoots. And there's a kick save by the pad. And there it goes in front. Another nice save. Fry comes out with it. He gets it across. He's trying to get to the red line. He gets it there. Chips it all the way in. Everybody was changing, so he's kind of by himself right now. And then Vineski's in there with him. Vineski tries to keep that puck there. Black's on it now. Black plays his man, and he'll pick the puck up. Black looks for the man open. Not able to get to it, so he puts it back to Vineski. Vineski puts it around to Slattery. Slattery to Vineski. Vineski still in the corner, has it. And it goes over to a Waxers player,
but
back to Black. So that was a miscue on the Waxers for sure. And Beasel retreats into his end, and it was supposed to be icing, but it didn't really make it to the red line. Beasel behind the net, set, waiting for Vineski to turn. Here he comes. He hits him. He's breaking out. He's got Black. Vineski goes, dumps it all the way down. Goalie gets a stick on it. But now number 18, but Black has it. He gets it out again. And they're coming back this way. Slattery, Black. That's a dangerous line out there. There's a beautiful hit. Beasel, he has the puck. He's looking. He gets it up high. Black's there, but Govindaris has the puck now. He heads the other way. He's in, over across, goes past the hash mark. Beasel picks the puck up, and he gets it out. There's Derrigan. He's got the puck now. North Bay Battalion's prospect.
Yes.
He gets it sent out. Henderson has the puck, cuts it across. And there we go, 39, shot. save by the Waxers goalie. No problem there.
I think we need to talk about how much this game means to these young men. The winner of this game, this isn't just some tournament where there's a winner and everyone goes home. The winner of this game is going to be in Member 2, Nova Scotia, starting April 22nd, the TELUS Cup. That's all the top AAA U18 teams all across the country. I believe there's five or six regions. And I know the Brandon Wheat Kings under 18 program is going to be there. So representing the central regions, either going to be Waterloo or Markham.
And here we go. The Wolves break out of their end. They work their way up and cross the red line, dump it in. Right on net. Hits a pad. Comes back out. Vader's on it. Me, he can't keep it. But he sends it out. Comes out. CeeLo Giannis on it. He also has Malloy with him. CeeLo Giannis goes behind his net. Stops. Hits the winger with the puck. Can't keep it there. Burke shot. Comes out. Rebound. No one's there to pick that up. And then that comes number 22. That's Malloy. Malloy sends it up to 39. Vanderberg. Vanderberg across to Vader. Can't do anything. CeeLo Giannis puts it back to Vanderberg. Then it comes to the point. Shot. Rebound. No one's there. 27 has it for the Waxers. He dumps it out to center ice. They just rim it back in, or try to, the Wolves, and it is there behind the net. Sorry, I couldn't pick the puck up for a minute. And here they come back the other way. Now it's Bert. He pushes it over to his partner, and they just dump it into the zone, and that's 58 Solomon on the puck, and he got it over to Collins, but he couldn't keep it. So Ratcliffe heads back the other way, and he has Miller with him. Miller, Ratcliffe.
Oh! Yeah! It's
that
in the net!
Top Jenner!
Oh,
right
my
into
goodness!
The left corner, and we have a tie game.
And referee Gubberman saw it right away. He went goal, 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 and that's Sam Ratcliffe, his seventh of the tournament. Number 77. He is the Elmira Sugar King affiliate player. What a shot, the farm boy Sam Ratcliffe.
Here we go. They set back up. 13:42 left in the first period. Here comes Beasel over the red line, dumps it in deep, and Vanderberg's hard on the wall. Vader's still with him, comes all the way out. Beasel wasn't on the line, so he couldn't hold it. Comes back, and it goes across the blue line again for the Waxers. Derrigan's going to have to backpedal, but Beasel will beat him here, there, and they'll switch off sides. He rims it all the way around to Vader. Vader chips it out, ooh, but it almost goes right into the Waxers player. And now it comes to the point. It's at the point, and there's a shot, tip, rebound. And there, the Waxers have it behind the net. Comes out to Senkai at the blue line. He misses it. It has to go back, and they go back over the red line, dump it back in. Breeze out to play it. Deep Beasel, he sends it around to the winger. And the winger, Vanderberg, he breaks out. Sends it back up, but can't send it, hit beat Vader. So Beasel will have to backtrack. He's got Derrigan on the other side. He decides to go the other way, though. Henderson rims it around the boards, and it hits a stanchion and makes a funny bounce. Johnson has it. He tries to go around. He gets knocked down there, but there's no call on that play. And it comes back out, and they'll send that right back up. The Waxers and head in. That's Helfenstein. He's got Mikko Giannakis with him. Burt on the point, sent over to his partner, back to Burt. Burt takes a shot, and it's blocked. Then it's sent up, hits the mesh, and goes out of play. That was Schofield.
And the teams that have already booked their ticket into the TELUS Cup are the Kensington Wild, representing the province of Prince Edward Island. I believe they also pull from other East Coast provinces. The Brandon Wheat Kings of Manitoba, the Sydney Mitsubishi Rush of the Nova Scotia region, and the Calgary Buffaloes of the West region.
And it goes the other way. There's Schofield trying to get it, unable to. Goes back right to Bree. Bree stops it. Defenseman posts up behind the net. Sends it back out to Bree. Bree, or Fry, he sends it up. And it's dumped in by Craig. Craig puts it in. Schofield's pressuring Burt, unable to get there. He rims it all the way around. And now it comes out of the Waxers' end. Burt once again has it. He goes up to the red line. Dumps it in. Straight on the goalie. And that he'll decide to freeze that up and get a stoppage and play to his left.
And 11 minutes, 32 seconds left to go in the first period. Score is 1-1. Shots are 4-4. We'd like to thank our sponsor. It's a power play sponsor, JDM Sports. The goal sponsor, Thompson Hardwood Flooring. The period sponsor, the Sioux Thunderbirds, as well as the Sioux Concussion Clinic.
And here we go. They win the draw. The Wolves, they're able to get it out of their own end. Vineski's hard on it. He just hammers his guy. Slattery has the puck. He breaks in. Goes over to Vineski. Back to Slattery. Shot. Save by Callahan.
Nice save by Eamon Callahan. He's been one of the better goaltenders this tournament. He was a under-18 all-star in the OMHA. And it will be a face-off. And speaking of that league, the OMHA playoffs ended with the number one seeded Ajax team losing to the Markham Waxers. And that's how the Waxers are at this tournament today. And it looks like a bit of a miscommunication for the Waterloo Wolves.
No, they'll get a draw. So they'll get a change of players up on the forwards. Miller's out there now with Ratcliffe and McCleskey. And they win it, goes over. Ratcliffe shoots it on net, and that was a quick save for Callahan. Hit him right in the bread basket, so he'll drop down and freeze that, and here we go again. They're going to set Miller up against number 14, cruise it. Ratcliffe goes around, gets the puck, tries to put it in front, can't get McCloskey, and now it's on the way back the other way. Cruise it, chips it, it's no icing now. Caswell's in on that. That's the captain for your Wolves. And he breaks up. He tries to hit McCleskey, but he's unable to do so. Cruises it the other way with Adams. Adams, he's got speed. And I don't know, why is it all the guys that are fast wear 13?
Yeah.
Senkai has it. Sends it back to his partner, and he shoots it in. And there's the easy save for Breed, and he won't take any chances.
And the previous game earlier today at 10 a.m., the Ottawa 67s defeated the Vaughan Kings by a score of 4-3. 30 seconds left. Their top goal scorer, Turcotte, scored to win them the bronze medal. Now it'll be a face-off in front of the goaltender.
And Miller takes the draw. He ties up his player, and it's still there in the circle. But there it goes. Ratcliffe walks out with it. He has McCloskey and Miller there inside, but he can't do much. Burt picked it out. And Adams chips it. Hits the centerman. Now tries to get it over to the winger. Cruise it. Unable to. McCloskey just tries to get it to center ice, but he can't. Derrigan's back. Derrigan tries to play that puck. The man falls down. And now he's got to fight for it back there. He's got two. Miller is in there trying to help him out and dig that puck out. And the referees are letting them play still. The puck is still moving, so they won't blow it down until it stops completely, and they didn't. So Miller breaks out, and he dumps it back. Almost missed you there, that's for sure. Beasel has it now. Beasel's behind the net. Yeah, the boys curl. They come out. And McCloskey gave Mikko Janikas a little tap, love tap on the way by there. Comes back. Burt has the puck. Sends it over to his partner, and they'll break in now, and that's sent over. Johnson, he's out up there, and it comes back. Burt can't keep it in. Pardon me, Helfenstein, he's out there.
Oh.
Vader almost had that and picked that puck up. Now he misses it. Vander back, or shot,
he scores!
That's number 30. Who was that?
39.
Noah Vandenberg. He made no mistake there and puts that puck high on Callahan. And now we have a 2-1 game. These Wolves are back in it, that's for sure.
And well, 17-year-old Noah Vandenberg had 33 points in 35 games in the Alliance Under 18 League. He is a sniper. He's had a couple this tournament. Arguably the biggest goal, or not arguably, I'd say absolutely the biggest goal for number 39 this tournament so far.
And there we go, we'll get another puck drop here. It's just going to be outside of the Waxers bench, and Craig posts up to take the draw against Piggott, and the Piggott wins it, sends it back to his D-man, and that is Popov. Popov sends it out to Mikko Janikas. He comes. Look at the speed on him. He comes in, shoots, Nice pad C by Bree. And now there we go. There's the Wolves. They're trying to get it out. That's Schofield and Fry. And that's... see Schofield's head pop back there. I wasn't too sure. And they try to get the puck out. They do so. Pickett's on the way the other way. Caswell plays his man. Rutledge is back. He reverses it to Caswell. And that goes up and hits the steel roof.
Yeah,
so
like,
there will be a stoppage of play. And that will stay inside to the left of Bree.
Multiple OHL prospects in this game. The two highest draft picks were number 55, Sam Black, went in the fourth round to Barrie, and number 27 for Markham, Mankiss, went in the 10th round to Flint.
And there we go. Shot scores! That's what happens when you put pucks on net. That was scored by guy from the point, shot it. That was Oldenhoff. I'm not sure if it was tipped, but it was tipped by someone. Not sure if it was tipped by someone on the Waxers, and it goes straight in. So now we're back to 2-2. First period, 8:16 left in the game.
And Oldenhoff was second in his league in defensive scoring for defensemen. And what a shot. Just quickly snapped it on and went through the five hole of the goaltender.
And here we go. It breaks down. Goes out. Comes back. And Govindaris takes a shot. Johnson's out there. And Collins, that's a big line for the Waxers. Black has it, shoots, misses the net completely, comes all the way back. Derrigan keeps it in, and Vineski's on it. Black, he's in the corner there, and the Waxers play it up, try to get out, can't. Slattery's on it. Slattery, he keeps it in, rims it back to Vineski. Vineski has it, he pushes it back to Derrigan. Derrigan shoots, there's a drop. Almost Black had a chance to put it in. Black has it. Black puts it back, and it goes to the point. Beasel goes over to Slattery. Slattery gives it to Black. Black goes. He's trying to make something happen here. He looks for Derrigan. Derrigan shoots, and it goes wide. Slattery's on it now. Slattery just shovels it and puts it in front of the net. Just misses Black. Beasel on it. Beasel shoots. Gets it through, but it goes right into the glove of Callahan, and no problems there, that's for sure.
Yeah, nice save there. Like you said, no problems for the goaltender, Eamon Callahan, one of the better goaltenders in this tournament. He's been electric. He was an under-18 all-star in the OMHA, and it'll be a face-off in front of him. 7:06 left to go in period number one.
All right, and we have Miller coming in with Ratcliffe and McCloskey. They do it, take the draw. Mankiss has it, gives it over to Burt. Burt sends it up to Adams. There it goes, Adams, here he comes. Speedy Adams shoots. Nice blocker, shoulder save by Bree, that's for sure. Goes up into the mesh and out. So they'll still get a stoppage to the right of Bree now, and that was a great save. So we'll see what this line here can do with Adams out there. They're against the other speedy guys from the Wolves, so it comes back to the point. Across to Burt. Burt shoots. Blocker save. Number 77. He's on it. Ratcliffe. He goes. Burt or Miller's with him. Ratcliffe goes around the D. There's the rebound. CeeLo Giannis was able to go and keep it in, and Miller takes his spot for him. Smart move on the third forward there. And now it comes all the way back. Bree stops it behind the net. Miller's there. Miller starts to skate up. Gives it across to Ratcliffe. Ratcliffe puts it into center ice. Now it comes back. Burt. Burt will move it back out. And he gets it up to Cruzit. Cruzit puts it out. But he gives it right into CeeLo Giannis.
Yep.
So now Cruzit will have to just rim it all the way in. And they get a change. Now CeeLo Giannis pushes it to McCloskey. McCloskey has it. And Ratcliffe had to come in and help him. CeeLo Giannis heads the other way. He pushes it over to Ratcliffe. Ratcliffe keeps going. Popov stops him though. Popov pushes it out. Gives it up to Mikko Giannakis. Mikko's there. He has number 92, Helfenstein, as well. But he's trying to do it himself. He can't do it. So he goes. Wolves head the other way. And here we go. Henderson's out there as well.
Ooh.
And there's a shot. Goes wide. And the Wolves are now trying to do something to get going here, but they can't keep it in. So now Caswell, he has to keep it at the red line, just dump it back in. And there we go. Wolves are after it. Vader's in there now. Vader can't find the puck. So the assistant captain for, pardon me, the Waxers picks up that puck. That was Popov. Popov puts it back to Koza. Koza up to Mikko Giannakis. Mikko Giannakis breaks the line. Can't do much there.
Well,
now comes
change.
Back out. Here comes Vandenberg. Shot. Glass comes out. And Mikko Giannakis is on it. But he goes back to, gives it to number eight, and it's pushed right back into their Waxers end. Vader. Vader is on Senkai. Senkai, he pushes it over to his partner. They send it up to Johnson. He's something to watch, boy. He better, they better keep an eye on him.
Yep.
And now Beasel. Beasel is able to get it over to his partner. And now Fry sends it in. Schofield's chasing after it against Senkai. Senkai up on the boards. And we get a stoppage of play there.
Yeah, it just grazed the mesh there. And going back to what we were talking about a couple minutes ago, Nathan Adams had a nice shot on goal. Usually not a offensive, or not an offensive player, or should I say, he's more of a playmaker setting up his teammates. But you have to watch. He has a sneaky, underrated snapshot, and he could make a life trouble for the defense. And now here's the Markham Waxers with possession of the puck here.
And Craig's out front lurking around. And Burt now has it. Burt will break out. He'll skate up center ice, gets there, dumps it all the way in. And there's Beasel. He'll backtrack. He'll send it across to Derrigan. Or Kaz. No, Derrigan, pardon me. And he gets it out. But Burt has it once again. And that's Mankiss. He puts it up off the boards, and Govindaris goes the other way. He's got Johnson. He's got Collins. And here they go. We'll see what happens. Collins has the puck out to Johnson.
He scores!
Make no doubt about it. That line is a force to be reckoned with.
There you go. Number 91, Matt Johnson, in the right place at the right time. You know, that's just great positioning by the alternate captain for the Markham Waxers. His fifth goal of the tournament. His fifth goal of the tournament. He's been excellent. And that's a huge goal. I think his father, as we were saying yesterday, would rather have the one goal today than the four against the Greyhounds, because these goals are huge today.
Here we go. The Wolves break out. They come up the other side. Slattery has it.
Oh,
and
no.
He gets stopped. Cruise it. Gets put, hit, and they just try to dump it down. Cielo Gianna sends it up to Black. Black tries to get it to Vineski. Unable to do so. And here comes Adams again. Adams pushes the puck over. Here comes shot. Just misses. That was Oldenhoff again. Now it comes back to Black. Black breaks out of his end. Goes across the blue line. He's carrying that puck in no matter what happens. And he gets it in there. Oldenhoff up against Vineski. Oldenhoff gets it out. And the Markham Waxers head the other way. There's a stick check by, and he's going to get a call
definitely
on hooking for sure there. Senkai shoots. Glove save Bray. And here we go. The first power play of the game. And that will be going to the Waxers, because number 14 or number 10, Vineski, is going to go off for a hook.
Yeah, I'd say that's a hook. He got his stick in there a little too much. And yeah, pretty clear penalty. I saw a few of the Waxers' parents throwing their arms up before they saw the official put his up. So it'll be 2:39 left to go in period number one. 2 minutes of which will be a power play for the Waxers.
Here
and number 71 just falls to the ground.
Yeah, that's Collins. And it's chipped out all the way down. No icing as they're trying to kill the penalty. And here we go. The Wolves play in a 1-3 style for the power penalty kill. And hit comes back up. And Mankiss puts it across to Collins. Collins chases in. He's got Rutledge pinned up with the boards. But it comes back out to the point. Mankiss puts it into Govindaris. Govindaris down low to 71. Collins unable to wrap it. He tried to wrap it right in. Unable to do so. Burt over to Collins. Collins puts it back to Govindaris. Govindaris is on that hash mark. Tries to push it back. He does to Collins. Collins walks it. and he puts it back to Govinderis. They switch spots again. They walk the line a bit and then try to shoot. Bert has it. Bert decides to come back and go to his partner, but he totally sends it right out, so Mankiz has to retreat and get that puck. He's able to do so, but Oldenhoff misses the pass. The rest of his line gets a change. He puts pressure on, and there we go. The Wolves are able to dump that down. 43 seconds left in the penalty, and here we go. Breakout for the Waxers. Let's see if they can do something in the end of this penalty. Over to Senkai. Senkai. He comes in, stops. Oldenhoff's on the back end. Oh, Schofield just reached out, took away that for sure. Craig's with him. Schofield, all around, still has it. Shot. Callahan, smart move. He just puts it in his glove and stops that play completely.
That was really nice by Callahan. A little bit of a dribbling puck there, and he just swatted it into his glove, and no problem for him. 58 seconds left to go, a 3-2 game. I don't think we thought it was going to be this offensively heavy, but this is where we're at. Five goals
here
in the first period.
Yep, Miller loses the draw. That goes over to Mankiz, then back to Mikko Giannakis, he comes up. He tries to break through the D. He gets hit. Derrigan, he breaks out. Mikulski has it now. Mikulski is able to get it deep, and it goes to Bert. Bert has it, but Mikko Giannakis comes back. Adams now. Adams is there. He chips it. He keeps going. Gets across the blue line. He's got some help there, and it'll go in. Cruz, it will be on Mikulski. Mikulski and Cruz are fighting for it together, but it comes out, and Miller, he gets it out instead and dumped straight back in by 27, Mankiz. And now here we go. Miller has the puck. He skates with that puck out, and we got to remember these. Oh, the penalty's done, sorry. And it comes back, and that will be it for the first period. That makes it 3-2 for the Waxers going into the second. What a first period that was.
Yeah, unbelievable. Shots are 13-10 for the Waxers. Like I said, I didn't think it was going to be this offensively heavy, but we're in for a treat, aren't we? 40 minutes left. Shots, like I said, 13-10 for the Waxers. Score 3-2. And my name is John Ostrowski for Roger Dell. We'll be back in 15 minutes. Going to take a quick coffee break. See you soon.
And here we are back for second period action between the Waterloo Wolves, Markham Waxers for this gold medal game. And the puck's won by the Waxers.
Yep.
And they send it in. It goes all the way down. Number 18's in there deep for it. And it comes out to Helfenstein. And he puts it up to Piggott. Piggott across to, that's number 37, Kojianikas. He skates with it. Puts it back to Oldenhoff. Oldenhoff keeps the line. No, he doesn't. It's bounced out. Kane called that an offside. So now we're going to go and...
I didn't think that Piggott touched the puck. I'm wondering why that was an offside.
It came out of the blue line.
Yeah, but he didn't touch the puck, Piggott. It was offside on Markham, correct?
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't think he touched the puck, that's all.
Oh, sorry. No. Comes all the way in, and that's... The Wolves are breaking out now. Slattery, back to Vineski. Vineski, he goes in, shoots, just gets kicked to the side. Black, he'll have it now. Back, shoot, Slattery. Oh, no, goal! It goes on the line. To me, it looked like that was in the net, but I'm not too sure. I'll have to look at the replay. I'll get John on it or Jay.
Absolutely.
And here we go. Oldenhoff, he goes, pushes it in. Rutledge, he's trying to make something on it. Caswell, he tries to do something as well. And Piggott's trying to put it in front. And there we go. It goes, comes out. Govindaris keeps in, but no, comes the other way. Here comes Vineski. He comes, goes around. He breaks the defense, tries to go in, unable to. Burt's all over him. And now there we go. It comes back over to the other corner, and that will be Mankiss, who just flicks that up in the air and gets it out. And then the refs blow that down, and we're going to get a stoppage of play right in front of us.
Ooh, I don't know. That was close. That was really, really, really close. But not make a comment.
I think they're talking about it, but I could make a comment, but people are going to be able to see it. That's for sure at home.
Yeah.
And, I'm not going to comment either.
Yeah.
So here we go. Collins takes the draw. And it comes back. Derrigan, he pushes it over. And it's over to Beasel. Beasel puts it up. Vader's on it. Vader dumps that puck in. And he has Vanderberg chasing. He's got Vader as well in there after it. Man, that looks like to be also Mankiss is in there. He's trying to get that puck out. And but 71, Collins is on it. Henderson keeps it. Henderson tries to... puts it right into the glove of the Waxers goalie, and we'll get a stoppage right to his left.
Yeah, going back to that goal, of course, we'll leave our 2 cents on that one out of it because the referees already have a hard enough job. The refereeing has been phenomenal all tournament. So
I wonder, are those all the refs up behind the goal there? Standing up, yeah, so they probably know exactly what happened because
there's look at that
six
spot.
Referees that are standing above the net, so you know.
Is it the gentleman in the suits there?
Yes, sir. So here we go. Waxers break out. They dump it all the way down. We'll get icing.
Yep, going to go out and will be a face-off. And like I said, the refereeing doesn't matter who it was. They've all been phenomenal. I think we haven't really had many incidences of – you know, rough stuff and nonsense. There's like one or two, but that's just hockey, right? So they've done a great job of controlling the games and making their presence felt.
And now it comes back. There we go. The Waxers are moving out. Adams the other way. He goes, hits his winger right across. There's a bounce back out. Ratcliffe, he plays that puck. It comes out to center ice. Now it comes back, and there's Popov. He sends it up to Adams. Adams. He makes the goalie stop that, and we'll get a stoppage of play to the left of Bree.
Yep, gonna be to the left of the official or of the goaltender Bree, and it'll be. Looks like Miller looks a little unhappy. He'll be skating off, slamming his stick. Oh, he just wanted to stay on the ice there. I think he's a competitor, as is everybody on the ice out there.
And here we go. So now we're gonna have Craig out there taking the draw. He's going up against Butt. Craig, who's going to win? Kane, the linesman, telling the guys, push back. And here we go. CeeLo Giannis pushes it back, goes off the wall, all the way down. It's going to hit the goalie. No icing. Goalie's going to freeze it. We get another stoppage. So right now we're not getting a lot of flow because we're getting so many whistles. So let's see if these teams can get into a rhythm here and put together a few minutes of just straight hockey. So Craig will take that draw against Butt again. Craig takes it. Butt wins it. Sinkai gets it. And it goes back. He's got Fry and Craig on him. And it comes out all the way. Here comes Butt. Butt gets poke checked. Fry has it. Sends it across. And CeeLo Giannis, he'll dump it in deep. Craig will chase after it. And he gets there first. Unable to keep it. It goes to Sinkai. Now Henderson. He has it. And it goes back. And it's back at the point. Milo is able to keep it in. CeeLo Giannis is thinking about pinching, but he backs out instead. And there's Fry. He's got it. He's going to chip it, but Adams gets it and sends it out in front. No one was really there. So now he chases it up in the neutral zone, but he's unable to get that. And we got another offside there. So we'll get another faceoff right in front of us once more.
Yeah, we definitely want a little bit of flow to pick up. Nobody wants to see face-off after face-off, so we're hoping we'll get a bit of a flow in this game. And I'd like to thank everybody watching either on Sioux Sports TV or listening on True House Radio. We are at our, I think this is the highest number of viewers we've had all tournament, which is to be expected with the finals. 327 of you watching all across the province and country and world. We very much thank you for your support.
And there it is. It comes in Waxer's territory. Vineski, he's got it. He puts it back. Rutledge now. Rutledge tries to backhand it. Mikko Giannikas heads the other way. Here he goes. He picks up steam. He's got Helfenstein and Piggott with him. And the puck tries to get back to Piggott. Unable to do so. Rutledge for the Waxers will move. He tries, but he's got Helfenstein all over him, Rutledge, but they move, the Wolves move it. Black had it. He could not do much with it, so Caswell retreats, and they set it up, and once again, it goes up into the mesh, and we'll get another stoppage of play.
Yep, couple line changes. Looks like both teams bringing out a new collection of players. The OHL Owen Sound attack prospect Tate Collins in the circle, and he's gonna win the faceoff.
Goes back to Koza for Waxers, and Popov tries to dump it in, and there's number 91 Henderson. He wraps it around. Derrigan goes by him. Vanderberg gets labeled into the boards. Vader couldn't keep the puck. Govindaris. Henderson, he breaks in. Here he comes. What's he going to do? Goes around the net. He's looking, head up. And they've got Derrigan open on the point, but they came out too far to him, so he would have had a way, not enough time to get the shot off. So there it is, back in Waxer's territory. Now it heads out. That's the defenseman skating and pushes over it to Govindaris. Govindaris gets stick checked by Henderson, and Beasel will go. He goes around the net, and Henderson sends it across, number 39 sent it across there, and now the Waxers head back out, and they're headed the other way. And that was Vanderberg, I apologize. And he headed the other way, and now that looks to be Govindaris is out there, Johnson and Butt, right?
Yes.
Johnson goes off, so I'm sure Govindaris will follow his lead soon. And here we go. Butt has it. Sends it up to Oldenhoff. Oldenhoff breaks the blue line. There's Govindaris going off now. And there we go. We get a stick. Jacket comes back. CeeLo Giannis rims it around. Oldenhoff keeps it in. Now it goes into the corner, and Vader's able to dump it all the way down. The goalie comes out and plays it.
I don't know, yeah.
And that would have been icing if he didn't. So here we go, Oldenhoff. He breaks out. He sends it to Adams. Adams all the way across to the captain, and he shoots. Ooh. Piggott, and glove save.
And there it is again, Nathan Adams. Kid just setting another player up, and that's what he does best. He's a playmaker, and the guy I compared him to was a young Marty St. Louis, because he's not the biggest, most physically imposing guy out there, but he sets his teammates up, He puts guys in good positions to score, and he's so fast.
Here we go, puck drop. Bigot. Win, kind of wins it, but then loses it. And it's back to Rutledge. Rutledge to Caswell. Caswell, he puts it up the boards to Miller. Miller misses it. Icing again.
There's the right call this time by the goaltender, Callahan. Don't play it when it's an icing.
Yeah. So it's coming all the way back down once again.
Here we go, face off.
Miller, Pickett, back at the draw. And the Wolves win that. They come out. McCluskey, he gets hit.
Wow.
And there's Caswell carrying it. Shoots. Goes over top of the net. Ratcliffe tries to just dump it in. He's unable to get it deep. Now here comes Pico Jonikas. He goes, dumps it in deep, and Rutledge will go back and pick that up. He'll take it. He almost broke out right in front of his net and decided that probably wasn't a good idea. Now he heads up, sends it up, but Pigott, he catches it, sends it over to, tried to send it over to Helfenstein, but wasn't able to. Now it comes out, Mankiss, back to Collins. Collins comes. He's trying to send it over. Oh, he does, but Mankiss just couldn't get that. And now it comes out. And there's Ratcliffe. He's trying to get out. He can't do so. Collins gets labeled from behind by Ratcliffe. No call on the play there. It was just a simple hit, and no one was hurt. So they're talking, chirping, you know.
Yeah, it's part of the game.
That's
I don't
just
think,
how the game is. So
yeah,
Collins,
I don't think either of these guys should go to the box for that.
So here we go. We'll line back up. We got that big line, Johnson, Collins, Govindaris out there.
Big boys.
They're going up against Fry, Craig, and also number, I think it's 61, Schofield. Yes, it is. And it's dumped in, and it hits the mesh, and we're going to stop.
So many whistles this period. It's a little interesting. I didn't expect this kind of game flow, you know. Usually both these teams are high possession, quick offenses, and you know, not really materializing offensively for either of these teams this period, so we'll hope it turns around.
And there we go with Derrigan. He gets that puck off the draw, comes back, Schofield takes it. He walks it, brings it in. He should have dumped it off the Fry, but he didn't. Beasel goes back, icing.
And this is a perfect opportunity to thank our sponsors, the Power Play sponsor, JDM Sports. The period sponsor, Sioux Thunderbirds. Sorry, let me grab my notes. You think I'd remember it by now? Oh, and the goal sponsor, Thompson Hardwood Flooring. And thank you.
Go and
he scores!
Derrigan shoots from the point, and he takes it into that left corner. No problem. That North Bay Battalion prospect made no mistake there, and it makes it a 3-3 hockey game.
Wow, and you knew the Wolves weren't going to go away lightly, that's for sure. And these teams are so evenly matched. What a shot by Derrigan. That's the second time. Exact same shot. Yeah. Puck went in the exact same spot this tournament.
Here we go. Comes back. The Waxers have it. They're going to push it up. Mankiss pushes it up to Collins. Collins in a shoots. Save. And now comes back up front. Mankiss has it. And the net's off the stanchion. And that's something that's very, very relevant in Sault Ste. Marie.
Yes.
Not just this arena, in a lot of them. And be interesting to see if a lot of other arenas have the same issue. Saying they do, but you know, you go see watch NCAA games and they drill it down 6 inches and
yep.
But that's also dangerous because you run into that net and it don't move. It's going to hurt you.
Yeah, they
so,
do.
You know, it's either or. So Beasel takes the puck. He goes around the net. Beasel's breaking out, pushes it off to, that's Black. Black will come in. He's got, extends it back. Derrigan just missed it, hopped over his stick. And there's Govindaris. He's chasing after it. There he goes. He has it. He misses an open net. He almost was able to stuff it in there. Mankiss pushes it over. Govindaris shot. Comes around all the way around. Mankiss will have to retreat. Also Burt. Burt will get there first. He'll dump it off to Mankiss. Mankiss rims it around out to number 8. And Butt comes in. Butt got Johnson with him, was unable to get his stick on it. He goes off for a well-deserved change. Now it comes back out. Black. Black rims it in, and it hits number 10, Visneski, while he was going off, so we get a whistle there. So it's going to be outside of the Wolves' bench, and now it looks like Henderson takes the draw up against Butt. They line up. Henderson wins it, goes back. Cilo Giannis dumps that in, and it's getting chased. Coles is there, sends it up, tries to hit Adams, but it bounces off the boards funny. Comes back, Milo has it. He sends it up, and that was Vandenberg trying to reach for it. And it comes out, there we go. Coles, it turns, sends it up to Adams. Adams can't do anything. Henderson's trying to stick check him, can't do it. Adams has it again, loses it. Now there we go, and the Wolves just can't get to the puck. Comes back out, cruise it, over to Adams. Adams got picked, kind of, I don't know if that was a trip, it was kind of weird. Vandenberg, he has it. Now he turns, goes around the net. He's looking to pass it to someone, and he decides to just put it up on the wall to Vader, but he can't do much either. Malloy, back to Vandenberg. Vandenberg sends it across to Henderson. Henderson can't do anything. Popov's all over him. And it's icing, or pardon me, offside.
And yeah, going to be a change for both sides. And yeah, you can tell Adams is, he thought he got tripped up. He was looking around for the whistle for a little bit and disappointed to not get the call as Nathan Adams. And as I got cut off by Derrigan's goal, I will mention that our last sponsor is the Sioux Concussion Clinic. So thank you to JDM, the Thunderbirds, Thompson Flooring, and Sioux Concussion Clinic.
It comes back to the point. McCluskey takes a shot. Kick saved by the goalie. Another shot just misses wide. Comes back to Caswell. He rims it all the way in to Ratcliffe. Back to the point. Big shot by Rutledge. Goes yep. wide. Caswell dumps it all the way back in. Rutledge is going to pinch. Ratcliffe takes his spot. Good move on him. Miller pressing. Caswell again. He'll get the puck. Keeps it in. Goes back to Miller behind the net. Miller gets labeled, but he stays up and gets the puck. He tries to come in. Instead, he sends it back to Ratcliffe. Ratcliffe, he's over the corner, and he's get... Oh, no. 16 McCloskey was back on it too. But Senkai picks up that puck, and he gets pulled down. No call there. There's a hit from Helfenstein. That looked like from his right. Here comes Ratcliffe. Shoots over top the net. Hits the mesh.
Yeah, up and over Radcliffe's shot. Easily goes out of bounds, and shots are, oh, a little bit of rough stuff, a little bit of chirping from both teams, and yeah, the refs got to get in there and push those two guys away from each other, but 9:13 left to go in period number two. Shots are 16 for the Wolves, 17 for the Markham Waxers. Second period shots are 4 for the Waxers and 6 for the Wolves, one resulting in a goal. And nobody going to the box, so those two might have dodged a bullet. And here we go, face off in front of the goaltender to his right.
Okay, and here we go. It's Vader, it's Collins. Collins wins it, sends it back. Burt has it. Burt. He's going to look to get it out of his own end. He hits it off the wall. Derrigan's there pressuring, but here it comes out to Collins. Collins, he's in on it. Sends it over. Shoots. Scores! That's number 91 for the Markham Waxers once again.
That's his second of the day. Matthew Johnson. That's the exact same thing, too. Collins to Johnson.
Yep.
So these two are firing on all cylinders together. And the Owen Sound prospect setting up Johnson. He makes no mistake about it. Sixth goal of the tournament. No issues for him.
Here we go. 8:58 left in the second, and it's put back. Burt picks it up, and he's got his partner, Mankus. He sends it back to him. He puts it up to Johnson. Here it comes again. Shot.
Oh, what a
save. Comes out of the glove, though. He couldn't keep it. Now it's all the way down the ice. Mankus there. No icing. Fries on it. He's pressuring. Back to Mankus. And it goes all the way out. All the way to Johnson. Johnson's in. He makes a move on Piesel. He comes back around. Sends it up front. Unable to get it to his part. To another Waxer player. Govinderis is on it. Butts out there too. Govedaris goes off for a change. Johnson's still trying to get something on it. And the Markham goalie picks it up and just takes the stoppage of play to his left.
And let's talk about Matthew Johnson for a second. I knew for a fact he was very unhappy with the way he played in the beginning of this week. He didn't really do much, to be honest. He didn't have a goal, didn't have an assist. After that Sioux Greyhounds game, it was like a brand new player. I talked to his dad after that, and he was the one who told me that Matthew was upset with the way he was playing, and he just turned, it seems like he just turned it on.
Yeah.
And just a switch flipped for him, and he said, okay, enough of this fooling around, enough of this, you know, not contributing to my team, and he's just had turned it around, and he can honestly be a look for tournament MVP the way he's been playing.
Here we go. Vineski takes the draw. It's up against Butt, and Waxers win it. Headed the other way again. Adams, he's going to speed against number 22. That's Malloy. And he sends it up to Black. Black moves in with Vineski. Tried to put it back to Black. And Black there still has the puck. He puts it back to Vineski. Vineski can't keep a hold of it. Adams is on it. Vineski stick checks. And it goes over to Cruz it. Dumps it over. It hits the goalie. Comes back out. Slattery the other way. He's got Cee-Lo Giannis with him. Slattery looking for someone. Unable. And the Waxers just couldn't get touch the puck. Black. He tried to stop it there and unable to do so. Now it's dumped all the way down the ice, and there's icing.
And thank you to Producer Jay for this sheet that he made me. So here are the teams. Now I have a little bit better of a understanding who's going to be at the TELUS Cup. The West Region, represented by the Brandon Wheat Kings. Pacific Region, represented by the Calgary Buffaloes. The Atlantic, represented by the Kensington Wild. The Quebec, represented by the Cantoniers Mahjong, and the host region will be represented by the Sydney Rush. Of course, member two, I believe, is a neighborhood of Halifax, Nova Scotia. So, yeah, the Sydney Rush will be representing it. Or Sydney, Nova Scotia, rather, not Halifax. And it will be face-off.
Here we go. Puck drop goes back. Ratcliffe on it. Back to Caswell. Caswell dumps it all the way in. Miller, he'll get that. He picks it up. It's in the corner, and it gets out by the Waxers. Helfenstein has it now. He goes, gets pinned up, but it's dumped in. That's Mikko Giannakis. He's able to get that puck in, but it's stopped by Piggott. Piggott dumps the player, goes back to Oldenhoff, over to Sankai. Shot, just misses, and it's back to Helfenstein. Then it goes Caswell, Miller. Miller's working on it. Miller gets it. He starts to skate it out. Here he goes, and that could have been maybe interference, but here we go. Miller tries to cross to Ratcliffe, puts it back to Miller behind the net. He gets hit by Piggott. That's going to be a stoppage of play there, and we have a penalty call, I think. It looks like a head check.
Oh, that could possibly be 4 minutes. The referees are not really, they're not... They don't mess around with these head checks. They're gonna call them if they really see it, even if it's ambiguous. They're gonna be more inclined to call it just with the concussions and all that we've been seeing. So
that's a 2 minute call, yeah. Head check there.
That's the right call.
Vanderberg lines up. Collins is out there. Wolves are on the power play. Let's see if they can tie this game back up. Or Wax. Yeah, and here we go. No, Wolves. Rutledge has the puck. He's going to bring it over to the center. He's got the goals. Now Henderson. Henderson tries to put it in front. Scores! Shoots the puck. Goes 5-hole. And it goes straight in on Callahan.
And what do we say about shooting the puck? You always do it. You just, if you see a shooting lane, something in a situation like that, why not take the shot? There might be a rebound opportunity for all that, and Henderson with an easy goal. That's just the goal. He never even saw it, in my opinion. Went straight through his five hole. I think that's the second five hole goal for the Waterloo Wolves today. So maybe they now know where to shoot.
And here we go. Johnson back the other way. Now we have number 19 and picks that puck up. That's Rutledge. He tries to go up. Collins keeps it in. And there's that big line there. And it's dumped up and it's going to get a call, and it'll go back into the Wolves' end for a faceoff.
It looked like it hit the referee there on his shoulder, and it will be a faceoff in front of the goaltender Bree. The OMHA's Markham Waxers versus the Alliance Hockey League's Waterloo Wolves. We are so happy all 378 of you are watching. Thank you very much for spending part of your afternoon with Sioux Sports.
And here we go, puck drop. And that's one by the Waxers. Mankiss puts it on net. Ooh. Tip. Went off a few guys, almost went in. 91 has it. That's Johnson. He gets tripped up. No call there. Derrigan. Now Fry moves out. Fry. He's going to carry that in. He dumps it in. Goes in. Here we go. Burt has it behind the net. Hit by Craig. Back out to Schofield. He shoots. Misses the net totally. Derrigan shoots it in. He's just trying to get it deep so that he doesn't have to deal with it. Mankiss puts it over to Johnson. Johnson tries to chip it in. And that big line's still out there. Collins, though, goes off. And now here we go. It's put up. Fry. Beasel. Beasel put it to Fry, and he chipped it all the way down. Now Burt retreats, and he comes around his net. Sends it back to Mankiss. Mankiss breaks out. Govindaris chips it. Goes all the way in. He'll get a change. So will Johnson. Butts out there. He's got pressure on the Wolves. The Wolves break out, though. And there goes Black the other way. He's got Vineski with him. Malloy pinches, and he keeps it in. Malloy has it. He's got guys with him. Takes a shot. Whoa, just goes over the net. And now stoppage of play there as the net is off.
4:35 left to go in period two. Shots, Waxers 19, Wolves 18. And it's been an offensive game. I don't think we expected it to be 4-4 midway through the second, or closer to the end of the second, rather. So it's quite surprising that it's got this way.
And here we go, 5-on-5 here, 4:35 left. Let's do it. Cilo Gianna steps in, tries to get the Vineski. What a save by Callahan.
Had to be quick there.
That was a one-timer, but, you know, he didn't pick any corner or anything. I think he just tried to shoot to get a shot, and fortunately the goalie was able to put up a good save, and here we go now. The butt will get thrown out on that draw, and Adams will come in. And Vineski gets thrown out too. They're just going to throw everybody out. Black in there now with Adams. Black gets thrown out, and here comes
what did he do to get
Slattery.
Thrown out?
I am not sure. So here we go. Malloy, he shoots, unable. And there it comes. That's cruising on it, I'm pretty sure. Yes,
yep.
Dumps it in. And it comes all the way back and hit. And Adams tried to get to the puck, unable to. Oldenhoff keeps it in, goes over to Adams. Adams tries to hit butt, and he put it in his skates back. Adams able to keep it behind the net. It goes back to Malloy. He has it, sends it back. And here we go the other way. That's Slattery. Slattery tries to get around the players. Senkai's there, Adams there. And they were not able to hold the blue line, the Wolves. They go back in over the red line and dump it in. They will chase now. Waxers are trying to get it out, and they just dump it all the way down, but no icing as that puck was slow. It gets up to Black. Black comes in. Toe drag goes around to Senkai. Goes around the net looking for someone to pass to. And he doesn't find anyone yet, and he's just trying to do it. And he gets it back to Vineski. He's in the corner as well. Now he looks back, gives it to Rutledge. Rutledge shoots. He should have went over probably to Caswell there.
I think so too.
But, you know, sometimes you don't see that man open. Your blinders are on, right?
Oh, absolutely,
so
yeah.
So it's hard. And that will get a stoppage of play once again in the Waxers' end. And we have Miller against Piggott. Piggott, captain. Miller loses that. And it comes back. And there's Helfenstein. He has the puck. Piggott. He gets dumped by Rutledge. And there's going to be a call there.
And yeah, definitely a call.
That's a trip.
Yeah, you said Rutledge. Yeah, it will be Rutledge going off. I think that's his second penalty of the day, actually. And it'll be a 2-minute minor with 3:06 left to go in the second period. And we are up over 400 viewers, 407 on the stream. Thank you so much for watching. And that's, I think that's our highest total of the week. That's absolutely amazing.
Here we go, puck drop. Comes back, Collins can't get it, goes out. And it makes its way over the blue line. Senkai, he's got it now. Skates back, puts it behind to his partner. And now his partner goes over to the other side to Collins. Collins, Govinderis, Johnson out there. And here we go. Collins, he works his way in on this power play. And it goes back to Oldenhoff. Oldenhoff over to Govinderis. Shot, just missed. Oldenhoff, fans on it. Gives it over to Ratcliffe. Ratcliffe, he's on his way. He's on by himself. He takes a shot.
Oh!
And it goes high and wide.
Oh, my
goodness.
So
there's nothing there to be had. Now we're on it again. And here comes Oldenhoff. He goes across the blue line. Is he going to stop and set and wait for his teammates? He's unable to keep it as these Wolves. There's another call. Ratcliffe just tripped another Oldenhoff, I think it was. Yes, it was.
Wow.
So there goes Ratcliffe off on a penalty as well. So they will have 5-on-3 for a minute and 7 seconds. Then it'll go to 5-on-4.
And I'm going to say something right now. So this is no copyright infringement attendant. This is the TSN turning point right here. 5-on-3 penalty, have a minute 7 on it. It's going to be a double minor, so I guess that's a roughing and a tripping. No. Of course, we're going to wait. Oh, Rod's saying
that. Might have been a slew foot.
Okay, that makes sense. And we're going to wait for the call. We're going to actually wait for it on our software here.
Yeah.
Here's a 5-on-3. And
here we go. Miko Jonagas gets back to Burt. Burt shoots. Scores! From the point! Miss, I cannot believe I just saw him miss a glove hand.
Yeah, Jack Bree,
like,
yeah.
He is so good with his trapper.
Yeah.
And he just missed that one, goes wide. So, yeah, here we go.
And like I said,
that's 5-4. We still have one penalty left. The other one's done. And that 4-minute penalty, it stays. It doesn't go down to 2 minutes because there is a penalty on the board still. So that's the first one. Now they have another chance. And then if they get one before the 2-minute mark, it goes back to 2. So here we go.
I just want to say really quickly, like I said, this changes the complexion of the game now. All the momentum's on the Waxers. They got to work to get at least one more, get some breathing room.
Here we go. Govinderis, he puts it up, gives it over to Johnson. Johnson carries it in. Malloy almost held his jersey. Johnson gets it back to Oldenhoff. Oldenhoff pushes it over, and he can't keep it, Govinderis. Golden, and Johnson goes in to help, and Govinderis, or pardon me, there's three Waxers. They just could not get that puck. It goes right on to the goalie, and they'll backpedal there, and here comes Oldenhoff. He turns, goes the other way. Here they come, right through, across the blue line. He's headed towards the net. He just goes in, tries to chip it in. Back to Mikko Giannakis. He puts it across the side, and he tries to shovel it in, and the goalie will make a save and put his hand on top of that.
Yeah, good job by the goaltender, Bree, just not to leave any rebounds out. Easy glove save. Just over a minute in the second period. Markham Waxers fans are really, really happy about that. And here we go. I meant to say they're happy about the PA announcer announcing their recent goal, taking the 5-4 lead.
Yep, and the Wolves try to get it out. They do so. Burt, he retreats into his end. And he stops there, sets up. Miko Giannakis will take the puck, and he will hit the Bruiners and go. There he goes. Look at his – wait, you can't see his feet. His feet move so fast, you can barely see him. He's like the Roadrunner out there.
Yeah.
You know, he's just wild. And there's a stoppage of play once again in the Wolves' end, and it is going to be to the left of Bree.
Here we go, 42.8. Shots are 21-20 in favor of the Waxers. Sorry, 22-20 in favor of the Waxers.
And it's dropped. There we go. Collins loses it, though. Goes to Schofield. Schofield tries to get it out. He's still trying, unable to. And Johnson keeps it in. He's turns. Koza's there. Koza tries to put it in front to Collins, but unable to. Collins has it now. Collins works around. He puts it back to Johnson. Takes control. Goes back to Govindares. Govindares moves. He's looking. Looks for Collins. Back to Govindares. Looks for Johnson. He's in front. Shoots. Just misses. And Govindares gets a high stick. He touches it. He should have just left it and waited and faked out Vineski there, but he couldn't.
Yeah.
So there we go. Stoppage of play. 7.4 seconds left in the second period.
Yep, 7.4. And the story of this game is has been offense, offense, offense from two teams who have had lockdown defenses all tournament and lockdown goalies. The 5-1 Markham Waxers up 5-4. We still have 20 minutes of hockey left to go, which is just amazing.
Here we go. 3 seconds left. Oldenhoff will just take that puck behind his net and kill that period, and that will be it. 5-4, Waxers lead, but the Wolves still have a penalty. Minute 47 left into the third, so we'll see what happens there.
And shots for the second period, 10 apiece. Roddy and I are going to grab a coffee, and we'll be back in 15 minutes. From Waterloo to Markham and everywhere in between, thank you for watching Sioux Sports TV and supporting grassroots sports in the Algoma region. My name is John Ostrowski, and for Rod Trudell, see you in 15 minutes.
And here we go, back third period action for this gold medal game at the OHFs. And it's 5-4 for the Waxers going into the third period, 20 minutes on the clock. Penalty for the Wolves, 1:46, they've got to kill it. And they break in, Henderson has that puck, comes across, goes in, he's on penalty kill, but he is trying to kill it in his own fashion. Back to Beasel, great move, but then he hits Henderson in the back. But there is Vanderberg, he's on it. He tries to get it out, he does so, but Oldenhoff stops that, and back to Koza. Koza has it, over to Oldenhoff. Oldenhoff comes in, rims it, goes all the way around. Vanderberg there, not able to keep that puck in out of the Waxers, so it comes all the way down, and the Wolves get a change. Derrigan, Beasel's out there. And for the Wolves defensive, and Vader's up front here, putting a little bit of pressure on them. Burt, he goes across the red line, carries it, dumps it in. He'll go after it, but Beasel's there. Beasel dumps it out. There we go, 46 left on the clock, and the Waxers, they'll set back up. Here comes Burt, sends it up to Mankiss. Mankiss, the butt. Butt has cruise it. Butt moves in, goes behind the net. He's looking for someone open. And that looks like Mikko Giannakis. He has the puck, gives it to Burt. Burt shoots. Oh. Just missed a nice rebound was Mankiss. And here comes the Wolves. Vader, shot, gets a rebound. Can't grab onto it, cruise it, comes back, grabs the puck. And Cruz in a walkout with it now. Here he goes. Comes across the blue line. Hits Mikko Giannakis. Mikko Giannakis. He keeps that puck. He still has it. Sends it back to Helfenstein. Helfenstein unable to keep it. Cruz it's in there. Vineski, he's helping out. Caswell. And then it comes back to the point. Over to Sankai. He shoots. Oh. Just, I thought that was going to go top corner.
Me too.
And then it's moved. Here we go, that's Vineski. Vineski gets the puck, that penalty is over. Vineski cuts the blue, red line, over the blue line. And here he goes, shoots, just misses wide. Now it comes back, here's Black. Black, he's there. Hits Slattery in the slot, he almost put it in. Black once again, but he gets sticked here. Here's Johnson, he's on it. But the goalie, Bree comes out. Helfenstein's there, he shoots. And he misses wide. Johnson has it again. It comes back. He's got Piggott out there with him as well. And they shoot that. It goes over to the far side. That's Slattery. And he's got Vineski. Vineski picks the puck up. And here we go. Comes back. Black. Vineski. Vineski shoots it all the way in. It's dumped down. And there it goes to Senkai. Back over to Johnson. He's on the wing there, and he gets it, rims it up to Piggott, and he gets pushed to the board there. Malloy's back. He's got Govindaris all over him. Miller will pick that puck up. Gives it to Ratcliffe, tries to get it back to Miller, but it's picked off, but Ratcliffe picks it up once again. He sends it in deep, and here we go. It goes in. And it comes to the back end, shot, can't do anything. And then Johnson can't keep it. It comes out, that's Cilo Giannis. He's trying to keep it in, can't do so. Collins gives it over to Govindaris. He shoots, freeze, we'll get a stoppage of play.
Nice save by Jack Bree, and there it is. There he is out there, number 91, Matt Johnson. Two goals on the day, and he's been a clinical player for his team. Here we go, face off, 16:11 left to go, 5-4, Waxers over Wolves.
And for anyone thinking, we had a parent just come up.
Yes.
We are leaving the mics on for the awards and the celebration after so that everyone back home can hear and all that stuff. And we appreciate everyone watching. So here we go, Miller has that puck again. Let's get back to this game. And he gets dumped. Miller, back to Beasel. Beasel doesn't get to him, so they have to backtrack. And Govindaris breaks out. Johnson, Govindaris, Collins, they'll go take a seat on the bench. It goes over. Beasel breaks out. He's getting some steam, and he tries to put it across to McCluskey, but he's unable to hit him, so we'll have icing.
Yeah, easy face-off, icing. And, yeah, like Roddy said, don't go anywhere after the game. We're going to be broadcasting to you all of the awards and all of the medals, all that good stuff. So everybody back home can enjoy that along with us. 15:36, 3:01 p.m. here in Sault Ste. Marie, Ontario. Puck drop one by the Waterloo Wolves.
Yeah, and that's Fry. He dumps it, tries to get it to the net so Derrigan can get a shot. Derrigan's deep in there, the zone. And forward Schofield came back to cover him. And there's Craig. He's deep. Fry gives it to Craig. Craig has it. He puts it out front. Just misses that. Over to the other winger. Yep. Derrigan has to back check. And there's Beasel. Beasel over back to Derrigan. Derrigan looks. He's trying to give it to someone. Doesn't see anyone, so he just skates in over the red line, dumps it in. Fry, he's all over it. And he tries to get there. Craig dumps it in, hits Fry in the leg, so you're going to get an icing. It'll be called all the way down.
And we'd like to thank our sponsors, JDM Sports, the Sioux Thunderbirds, Thompson Flooring, and the Sioux Concussion Clinic on 644 Queen East.
And that's it. And the Waxers win that draw. Miko Giannis puts it back. And it goes over to Helfenstein. Piggott's trying to get it. And there is Rutledge. Rutledge tries to play that puck. Henderson's there as well. So is Caswell. But Piggott gets it. And he tried to kick it over to Miko Dejanikas, but he's unable to. Now it goes. It hits another Wolves player. Ooh. And he makes a few moves there. Unable to keep the puck. Piggott now. Piggott works in. And it goes in deep. And Rutledge has it once again. He reverses it to the captain, Caswell. Caswell stops behind his net, sets, waits for the wingers to curl. And there they go. Piggott lost his stick.
Yep.
He gets it now. And Henderson goes, breaks the blue line, and he gives it up. Gives shot, misses, blocked. 2-on-1, here we go. That's Miko Giannikas. He's just missed a pass. There he got it,
he scores!
Miko Giannikas stays with it. Misses the first one. The other player picks up the rebound, puts it back to Miko Giannikas, and he makes no doubt about it, puts the puck in the net.
Andreas Miko Giannikas. He's going to get rewarded with a gyro and some baklava after that one. The Greek-Canadian player with a beautiful rebound goal.
Here we go, and that's 6-4 for these Waxers. And here it is. They come out now, and that's number 5 for them. He sends it up high. It goes wide. They're going to get an icing. And that was Koza that misplayed the puck there, and it comes all the way back. And these Wolves, they'll pick it up. They're not done yet. Lots of time. 13:36 left in the third period, and it's brought back. Black shot on net. Doesn't hit the net though. And Slattery's in there. Vineski's in there. Black circling. Black gets it. He shoots. Hits the goalie's pad. Goes wide. And it's dumped back into Slattery. Back out front. And it goes the other way. Here's Johnson. Johnson takes that shot. Goes wide. And the PA announcer just giving out the goals. Yep. Adams gives it back. Here we go. Butt shot. Saved by Bree.
And we got to remember what the stakes are of this game. So the winner of this, as everybody knows, will be going to the TELUS Cup in member 2, Nova Scotia, representing the Central Region. It looks like the Central Region is, I believe, the last one to be decided. Jay is shaking his head. As before that, the Quebec Region, Conteneo's Mahjong was the one that was previously decided before this one, and here we go.
It's brought back, shot quick, goes all the way back to Burt. Burt puts it in deep, and there we go. Miller chips it up to Ratcliffe. Ratcliffe over to McCluskey. Kleski can't control it. Adams in on it now against Derrigan. He gets dumped by Derrigan. And now we've got, comes back to Adams. Adams shoots it up front. Shot. Big save.
Yep.
Glove, but comes, bounces. Here's Miller. Miller, he's looking to give it to someone. Instead, he does cross ice it, but he's offside. Delayed offside right now. And unable to keep it. There's Caswell. And that's Piggott. Piggott's hard on it. And there we go. It comes all the way back to Senkai. Senkai, he brings it back behind his net, gives it over to his partner. His partner sends it across to Mikko Giannakis. And Mikulski dumps it back in deep. And there's Bankis. He sends it out to Helfenstein. Piggott gets played, but he hits his guy. The guy's helmet goes flying off. We're going to get a penalty there, as I think Piggott landed on top of him and body slammed him or something.
And it looks like the Waterloo Wolves will be getting...
Yeah, you're right.
No, the Waterloo Wolves will be getting a two-minute power play, and it's almost poetic how they go down two and get a great opportunity to make something happen and cut that lead in half.
Yeah.
They got to score here, I think.
Yeah, they
got to. Because Callahan's been great today. Four goals on 23 shots isn't the best save percentage. However, when you consider the type of shots that he was facing, that's pretty darn good.
Yeah, for sure. So here we go. And there's the puck drop. Wolves win it. Back to the point. Over to Slatter. Here he goes. Can't get a shot off. He's got Butt chasing him. But he can't get it. Vader back to Slattery. Slattery, he walks over, gives it, shot. And it's goalie had eyes on it and able to save that puck. And there we go. The Waxers are able to dump it down. They get changed to forwards. Here they come. And they'll go into a 1-2-1 now. And they keep it. There's Johnson. Johnson, he goes, oh! That was definitely offside. I don't know how he thought he was onside. He is definitely offside.
I don't know what happened there. Collins and Johnson are two guys who, when they play together, they're so lethal.
Yeah, he thought he got his leg back. He should have stretched more.
Yeah, the Owen Sound draft pick. Yeah. Tate Collins will be taking this faceoff.
There we go. Comes back. Ratcliffe sends it over to Caswell. Caswell up to Vineski. Vineski dumps it back in. And Johnson, dumped it back in. Breed comes out, plays at Caswell. They'll wind up, and they'll break out. Here we go. Ratcliffe's on his way out. He's got Fry. He's got Vineski. He's got Black. And he has the goalie making a stoppage. So we have a faceoff.
Easy save for the goaltender. Easy stoppage. And 58 seconds left. I don't think this is the type of power play the Waterloo Wolves have wanted. Haven't really even gotten a shot off.
No, it's uncharacteristic, but it is what it is, right?
Yeah, absolutely.
So Vineski there takes the draw, and he gets thrown out, though. And Black will move over. Fry comes in. And there it is. It rimmed all the way around. Goes all the way down the ice, and Bree comes out to play it, to stop it. Caswell will pick it up behind the net, and they'll turn and burn. Here we go. Ratcliffe goes the other way. He comes across the blue line. Mankis tried to check him. Nice shot on net. And, that was nice of, who was that?
14.
Number 14, but he kind of ran into Ratcliffe. Ratcliffe was going to fall, so he hugged him and kept him up.
Yeah, good sportsmanship from all these young men.
Nice to see. And Vineski takes the draw, and he just loses it and gets dumped down. And Bree comes out and plays it. Caswell will have to retreat back once again. 27 seconds left in this penalty. And there we go, Ratcliffe. He's coming back across. He goes here. Let's see if they can make something else happen. And Ratcliffe keeps going around the horn. There he goes. And it gets a shot off, but Butt is able to block it. Ratcliffe picks it up once again. And he just dumps it up to the front. And Burt able to get a stick on it, and it hits the mesh.
And 9:52 left to go. Shots are 28 Waxers, 26 Wolves, 428 viewers. 433 viewers in the stream. we just like to thank you so much for joining us all weekend. It's just meant the world to be able and bring these games to everyone. It's been such an awesome week.
Here we go. Johnson, he tries to give it to Collins. And that's it. Schofield has it. Schofield comes in. He gets the goal. He tries to give him a right hook there. Yeah. And that's it. Senkai has it.
And, yep, Senkai has it. Here comes the Markham Waxers. And he loses the puck, goes down into the defensive zone. Oh, no, not what Callahan wanted, but it'll be fine as the Markham Waxers have the puck. And now it goes out around. Here's Senkai, the Barry Colts draft pick. Flips it up, and that's not where he wanted the puck to go, that's for sure. It's just going to go around. Here's Sigliotis with the puck. He's waiting. He's waiting again. And trying to see a little bit of movement, but not liking what he's seeing. Now he's going to come out. He's coming out. He's passing the ringette line. And nothing going there. And Johnson going to dump it in. Get some fresh legs. Here comes Nathan Adams. Here comes number 11. That is not number 11. That is number 16, Klavit. And now here come the Waterloo Wolves. Here's Craig. Kaysen Craig flips it in. Dump and chase. Here's McCloskey. Kaza goes around. Retrieves it. Now here's Nathan Adams. Wow. Nathan Adams lost the puck. I don't think I've ever seen him do that before. Now here's McCloskey. He's going around, trying to make something happen. Kaza's on him hard. Great defense by Kaza. And yeah, you can tell why the Barry Colts drafted this guy. He just shut down the Waterloo Wolves player. Now he's shutting down another player. Yeah. What a defensive effort by Kaza. But here's the Wolves. They're attacking hard. Puck flips around. Now Popoff has it. Markham Waxers flip it off. Here comes Adams. Nathan Adams streaking in, just not fast enough. Not something we usually say, Adams isn't fast enough, but that time he wasn't. And here come the Waterloo Wolves. Here's Vandenberg. He gets checked, but there's Matt Miller. Matt Miller, the Guelph Storm prospect. And now here's Burt.
All right, I'm back, Burt.
There he is.
And here it comes. Back to the Miller. Miller has shot.
Oh,
big
what a
glove
save.
I apologize. I had to leave for a minute. I got a stinger there. Felt like a puck hit me. My leg slid off the thing and cranked the table.
Ouch.
So, yeah, I got a big cut on it there now. So who says you can't get hurt in the booth?
Hockey announcers are just as tough as hockey players.
Miller loses that draw. Comes all the way back, though. Beasel keeps it in. Beasel goes back to Miller. McCloskey's in there. Miller tries to do something. Spins out. He's looking to give it to someone. Gives it over to Derrigan. Derrigan, he dumps it in deep. McCloskey's going to be after that. He gets hit kind of from behind by Senkai, and it gets chipped all the way across the ice, and that looks to be Helfenstein on it with Piggott. Piggott, Helfenstein pushes it over. Mikko Giannakis is out there well. Here's Piggott. Piggott tries to keep hold of the puck. He's got Derrigan there, so he's going to have to do something special to get away from him. And him, there's Beasel. Beasel going with Ratcliffe, but Ratcliffe got dumped. And now the puck gets chipped up, and it just goes down the ice and hits the goalie. No icing there. Derrigan, he'll have to go behind his net and get set. Here we go. And they start to curl. Vineski, he's with number 19, Rutledge. Black breaks over the blue line. He carries it in, and it goes behind the net. Slattery's there now on it. Slattery tries to put it in front a bit more, unable to do anything there. So now it comes out. That's Rutledge. Rutledge over to Caswell. Caswell can't get anything on it. Govindaris is on it. He's got Collins. Collins is in the corner. He cycles it to him. And Caswell's giving Collins the whole how's she going, and then it comes out. That's Vineski. Vineski pokes it up to Slattery, but Vineski, they're gonna try and do something here. They gotta get a goal, and here it comes. Adams, it gets dumped all the way down, and we've got icing.
And yep, icing. 29-27 are the shots in favor of Markham. Coming down the rink, 5:48 left to go in the period, and we're up to 457 viewers. Thank you very much for watching on Sioux Sports TV.
And we get that puck drop. Here we go. And Vineski loses that. Koza gets it all the way across. Goes past Popov and hits Cruzit. Cruzit gets stick checked, but it goes back to number 22, and he sends it up to Beasel. And Black hammers his guy, Cilo Giannis. He goes back and picks that puck up, and he's got to go get it in the corner. And he skates with it. He tries to get it up right to the blue line, over the red line, over their blue line. He's going in. He gets past Koza. Now he's in the corner, and he's still fighting for it. Now he retreats back to the blue line. And there's 28 Popov with that, and he gives it up to Cruz it. He skates over the red line, tries to dump that in, unable to. Cilo Giannis tries to hit Vader. There almost was a pretty big collision there. Cruz it. He gets hit by Vader. It's dumped in. Beasel's back. He loses the puck, and he retreats and picks it back up. Beasel breaks out. It comes into the neutral zone. Beasel over the red line tries to dump it in, and Mankiss is able to get that puck and bring it back to his partner, Bert. Bert over to Mankiss. Mankiss, he sends it up to Mikko Giannikas. He comes in. Here he is. He's against Beasel. Kicks it. Unable to do much. Vader turns, burns. Here we go. He comes across the red line. He's over the blue line. Now he's going to go and hit Bert. Boom. There it is. Number 39's on it. But it comes back to Derrigan on the point. He's got a good shot. Just misses getting it off. Good. So it comes back again. Henderson takes up on the point, but it's dumped all the way down the ice, and it'll hit the goalie. The goalie will take control. He sends it all the way up to Henderson. Henderson tries to get it across to Vader. Unable to. Bert. Oldenhoff wasn't able to really get it out too far, so it comes right back in. Number 44, Craig for the Wolves has it. He now looks, sends it across, and he's trying to get it going, but it's just these waxers seem to be shutting them down. Now, that looks like Govindaris, and the goalie just puts that in the glove and says, let's get a breather, boys. 3:22 left in the third.
And here we go, 3:22. The biggest thing for the Waxers is they got to stay focused for three more minutes. And so do we, Roddy. I know we're both tired, and Roddy's falling asleep here.
And here we go. Number 18, Oldenhoff, sends it up, and it hits the mesh. I don't know if I've ever fell asleep standing up. Here we go. It's been an amazing week,
so rewarding.
I'll tell you, it's been, and these parents have been classy from all out of town. We haven't had too much trouble at all. It's been great. So here we go. It comes back. Back to the point. Shot. No, it doesn't get through. And now let's see what happens. Comes back to Caswell. Caswell, he gets it back, but he can't get it in. It gets flicked up. Collins. Collins is in on it. He's trying to get the puck. He does get it in deeper, and now he's going to go get a change. Govindaris, he's pressuring, and now they break out this way. Caswell comes. He dumps it in, and Koza's there. Koza has it. Gives it to to Adams. Adams just flicks it in. Look at that. Goalie is pulled. 2:37 left, and they pull their goalie. Smart move as far as I'm concerned, because the only thing you want to do is win if you want to get to that cup. And there it is. It's dumped in all the way. Popov on it. Popov sends it out. Ratcliffe gets it. But that gets out. It's sent all the way down. Derrigan's going to chase after it. It's going to be icing. Adams could not get that.
We almost caught up to him. He's so fast, man.
So now we're going to have a stop, drop puck right in the Waxers' end. We're going to see a timeout by the Wolves. They're going to draw up a play. So here we go. Let's let them do that. We'll take a break, and we'll come back right after that. Here we go. We're back from that. And parents are starting to cheer here. Vineski takes the draw, and Piggott gets called out, butts back in, and Vineski wins it. Ratcliffe shoots, and Black's on it now. Black, he keeps it there. He's going to go behind the net. He's going to try and give it to – he gives it off, and – now he's going to give it back to Rutledge. Rutledge shoots. Here's a shot.
Oh,
scored!
Here
off the rebound. Callahan. It bounces out right to the stick, and he puts it in. No questions asked.
And what do we say about a two-goal lead?
Worst lead in hockey.
Worst lead in hockey. That is Sam Ratcliffe, number 77. Or sorry, that's not number 77. Yes, it was. I do apologize. I'm looking at my Markham sheet. The Elmira Sugar King affiliate player gets that one. He's in the right place at the right time. One goal lead.
1:58 left. Here we go. Let's see if the Wolves can get her back. And they're going to try. Koza over the red line. Dumps it in. Bree comes out. Stops it. He's behind, the player's behind the net now. That is Caswell. He breaks out. He gets cross red. Sends it in deep. They're after it. Vineski's going to get there. Vineski, Ratcliffe. It goes back. Vineski, he's digging. Ratcliffe, he's digging. So's Henderson. Henderson, he's on it. Gives it back to Vineski. Vineski tries to push it over to the corner. Can't. It goes back to Caswell. It gets out by Helfenstein. Now it comes over to Ratcliffe on this side. Ratcliffe, he goes in. He dumps it in deep. Vineski's after it. He has Burt back there. Burt tries to get it out, unable to. Caswell, he keeps it. Burt gets it out. And now it comes to center ice. Chipped all the way back in again. Minute and 5 seconds. Here we go. Caswell, he loses it. Ratcliffe gets dumped. And there we go. Gets hit off the boards. There's going to be icing. They're going to have another chance to set up another play. And they'll try and probably do the same thing they just did. So it is 6-5, 54.7 seconds left in the third. 30 shots on goal for the Wolves, 31 shots for the Waxers. And here we go. Yep, and here we go. Vineski, he's going to take the draw. He loses it. Burt turns. He shoots it all the way down. We're going to get a call again, icing.
Oh, man.
So they'll set right back up. And the parents are saying that it was deflected off something, but it wasn't. So here we go. It gets called. And that means Vineski's. No, he's not taking the draw. Henderson does. Henderson wins it. Back to Cilo Giannis. Cilo Giannis back in deep, and he doesn't. He's got to get a shot on net. They've got to open something up here. There it is. Shot on net. Vineski tries to put it in. Black's there. Black. Or Vineski puts it back to Cilo Giannis, back to Ratcliffe. Ratcliffe tries to shoot, unable to. It goes all the way down.
Oh.
This is the net. Icing once again. 24.9 seconds left.
Yeah.
They still have a chance
to tie
this game up. That is a lot of time. That's for sure for this high-powered hockey team.
I don't know if he should have iced the puck there. I would have used the glass and maybe chipped it up and over, but doesn't matter now. 25 seconds left in the game.
And there we go. Rutledge cuts cross. She finds the opening. Oh. Shot on net. Save.
And this is the biggest game of Eamon McParland's life. The biggest 20 seconds of his life, that is. And he's got to stand tall. He's been great today.
Yeah. And here we go. Henderson takes the draw. But wait a minute. They got to let Johnson get off that ice. Henderson drops the puck. Here we go. Over to Rutledge. Rutledge misplays it, but he gets it back. And Henderson has it. Shoots. Hits a side. And Black's out there. Back to Henderson. Back to Rutledge. Shot. Deflection. Just misses going in. And here we go. Black is going to try and put it in front of the net. He does so. Unable to keep it there, though. Then they win. The Markham Waxers are going to the Telus Cup. And that is a heartbreaker for the Waterloo Wolves that went through the tournament undefeated. But these Waxers came out and they played in the right time and the right way during this game. They were they had to do what they had to do, and they did it. And they will be headed to the Talis Cup, and I'll tell you, what a play. And it's, you know, you feel bad for the other Team Wolves players. They are all on their knees sitting there heartbroken, but they got to get their heads held high.
Yeah.
Their parents are proud of them. They're all cheering for them. The Wax Scissors are all still celebrating. It is hard to watch. I've been on both sides of that, and it don't feel good over there, but it feels great on that side.
Yeah.
So there we go. That was one hockey game. I was glad to call that and happy to call it. I'm going to go off here. I'll let John finish off as my voice is gone.
Absolutely.
Thank you for joining us.
And absolutely, just full credit to the Waterloo Wolves. They were in it for 60 minutes. This was one heck of a hockey game. And we had over 500 viewers. That's amazing. Thank you so much, everyone, for, you know, this entire week. It's been absolutely fantastic. I'm not going to talk for too much longer. There's some really, really emotional parents down there. And your players of the game for the for the Waterloo Warriors, number 91, Rowan Henderson. And for the Markham Wactors with two goals, Matthew Johnson. And you can see the emotion. These kids on the Markham team, their year is not done yet. They will be moving on to the Telus Cup in number 2 in Nova Scotia. And we're going to let the PA announcer do his thing. Thank you, Sioux Sports TV, signing off.
This year's top defenseman for the Waterloo Wolves is Thor Caswell. This year's top goaltender for the Markham Waxers is Ethan. Number 66, Number 88, Cameron Wiesel.
Mason Cruz.
Absolutely.